So what we're going to do today is we're going to look at the seaweed that's in these rock pools. And you're all of you going to get about half an hour each going out snorkeling as well. So you'll see the seaweed in its real life. Because of course seaweed lies on the rocks, but that's just like us asleep really. Because for the other half of its life, it's like it flows more beautiful than even the best woods you've ever seen. The other thing to let you know is that you'll all be given at least 13 shots on an underwater camera. You can take the underwater camera with you when you're snorkeling, but you can also use it while you're rock pooling. Because it's underwater, you can actually put it underwater. So don't forget to use your camera. And also Paul's got buckets and some information sheets. So we've got lots and lots to do.
It is, isn't it? It's thick, sort of.
Do you think that stuff being washed down from the river, well, from the...
Yeah, it's probably getting... I'm just going to stick my hand in there. Oh!
He
was big! Look!
He's amazing!
I've just got him out.
Do you want to take a picture of him?
Yeah, give me my camera first. I'm going to actually stick my head underwater as well. It's going to be fun.
I think
he might be that one.
Oh, he's handsome.
You look at his lips, he's got big lips. That's how you tell them actually, he's got very big lips.
Lovely markings.
And the lips are normally always quite pale. They've got no scales. So they can breathe through the skin. So they don't need, they can be out of water. And sometimes on nice days, they actually come out of the water onto a rock to sunbathe.
Good gosh.
And then they like a mud skipper. They can bite, they feed on barnacles.
He's not gonna bite you, is he?
One of them bit me once and it did hurt.
I wish we could get onto that bit so we can have a closer view.
Maybe we can do that when we're snorkeling.
Yeah.
Go snorkeling here.
On that. Because this rock pool is really big, really deep.
How deep is it? I reckon that's the best place to go snorkeling.
Look at his tassel. So over here we go snorkeling.
Or over there. Wait, okay.
Right, trap him.
Oh god.
It must be like a mating.
What?
He's gone.
Mating pair. Right.
I'll lift up this.
There's another.
They found it right in the crevice. I mean, what they do, they actually wedge themselves in the crevices. So they protect it from all the storms. But that's quite a big crab.
What's that? Is that a type of crab?
A big one.
It's not a crab, it's a... Look at this.
That's a top shell. That's a top shell.
Yes.
But that's right in the crevice.
Back down.
But actually, in terms of crab size, that's quite... It's not as big.
My granddad's been... pinched by a crab like that, like that big.
Do you know, I don't think I'm going to walk bare feet in any rock pools now.
And what happened is it held onto his nail, and his nail came in two.
Oh.
Oh.
It's weird. It's really cool, isn't it? Maybe that's a special type of seaweed.
If you leave it out, no more.
Okay, in hand. Well done.